Keeping your drivetrain clean is essential to prolong the life of it. Not only that though, it'll make sure that you get crisp shifting every single time. The first thing that you've probably spotted is the fact that my bike is filthy. So before we get into this mechanical, I'm gonna take it outside and give it a good wash. So you can see now that the bike is actually a lot cleaner. I've gone over the drivetrain just with some bike cleaner. However, it's not quite cleaned up 100%. So what I'm gonna use now is a little bit of drivetrain cleaner and some smaller brushes, really to work in that formula into the cassette, the chain, into the jockey wheels. If you are using a spray lube right here, just be very careful where you spray that. You don't want to get it onto the disc brakes, because you could worry about contaminating it and your brakes just won't be as strong as they're meant to be. Okay, so the main areas I'm just really focusing on getting these smaller detailed brushes in is like the cassette, getting right in there and making sure that all the dirt and the grime is right out, and then the chain. And the easiest way I've found to do this is just take your brush and just back pedal. You're probably gonna have to add more cleaner on as you go, and then just keep working it in until the chain starts to look a lot cleaner. Switch it around so you're getting the sides, backside, and then onto the top. And then you can get onto the chainring, scrubbing away. You'd be surprised, all these little teeth just really catching the dirt and the grime can really build up. And if you're running one of these narrow, wide chainrings, you can actually find that that dirt buildup just won't allow the chain to sit and it could actually jump off. So make sure you give that a really good clean. Again, if you're using a strong degreaser that's not bike specific, just be careful where you're putting that. You don't want to get that into the bottom bracket or into the hub, the free hub, etc., because it's gonna wear away where the grease is actually meant to be. Okay, so I think we're just about done. One last place, and that's the jockey wheels. Just to give them a bit of a clean up. And we're looking not too bad. Okay, so with it all cleaned up, it's really important actually just to rinse that degreaser off, make sure that none of it gets stuck in there. Otherwise, when it comes to lubing it back up, well, the chain oil is not actually gonna stick onto it. So just be really thorough and just ensure that at this point, you could be checking to make sure that it is cleaned up well and that you've not got that dirt and grime still stuck in there. And I've got to say, it's looking pretty good. Well, I think I'm pretty happy with that. It's time to take it back up into the workshop and get on to the next stage. Okay, so just by looking at that drivetrain, I can actually see that it's pretty immaculate. I'm impressed with my own cleaning skills, I've got to say. We're just gonna take this dry rag to it now, clean up the jockey wheels, the chain ring, and dab down the cassette to make sure there's no excess degreaser and that the lube, when it comes to re-lubing, is gonna stick to the chain and do what it's meant to do. Okay, so the drivetrain is all cleaned up. If your chain was particularly black, then you might have to do this whole process all over again to get it spotless, looking kind of similar to this. Or you could alternatively use one of those chain baths where you actually clip it onto the chain itself, you fill it with degreaser, and it runs it back and forth. This is quite a messy job, but it is definitely the most effective way if your chain is filthy. Now it is time to get onto lubing it back up though. Okay, so I've got a wet lube and a dry lube. Now these vary depending on your conditions. It's winter right here where we are, so I'm gonna use some wet lube. If it's drier conditions, then you definitely want to go for that dry lube. I don't want to get too much into the details, but that dry lube just won't pick up dust and dirt to sort of contaminate the whole chain. Whereas if you're using wet lube in those drier conditions, what you actually find is it's gonna create eventually a black grinding paste just because it picks up the dirt. It sits in the chain that a little bit more to give it extra protection. So just think about what lube you're using depending on your conditions. I'm gonna apply some of this wet lube now, and I've got three places I like to apply it to. Apply it onto the chain, of course, then onto all these pivots on the rear mech, and then just onto the bearings of the jockey wheels, just to keep everything running smooth. So finally, I'm just gonna get rid of that excess lube, cleaning up the chain, jockey wheels, and also around the rear mech. And that is it, job done, and I'm ready to get back out and hit the trails. If you want to watch some more videos from GMBN, then I suggest you click on that logo right there to subscribe. because you'll never miss another one. And to watch some videos from GMBN, why don't you click there for the full bike wash and click down there for how to fit a new chain. Don't forget, if you're gonna do this process, then give it a thumb up like.